fentanyl distributors are driving violence in the city.
But we've also seen increase in deaths associated with fentanyl, which has become a very large problem.
Well, that is Baltimore City State's Attorney Marilyn Mosby and Interim City Health Commissioner Mary Beth Haller. Our State of Baltimore series today is focused on the opioid abuse problem in the city, specifically C4 fentanyl.
Yes.
And 566 overdose deaths due to fentanyl in the first 9 months of 2018 compared to 428 the first 9 months of 2017. 32% increase. Other categories of overdose deaths have increased, except for heroin deaths. And one of the reasons that they are down is usually the heroin addiction has started with prescription drug addiction. And Mary Beth Haller told me that the efforts to try to curb opioid prescriptions and limit them and have pharmacists and doctors warn of the risks, those are starting to pay off.
When we look at this whole issue of heroin / opioids, Robert, and particularly in Baltimore, Baltimore has been the epicenter of heroin for almost 50 years now.
Yep.
You look at report after report, whether it's National Geographic back in 2014, whether it's ABC News back in 2001, we have consistently had this heroin problem. Now you add into it the issue of fentanyl. The DEA just started back last year, at the end of 2018, this 360 program where they're working with the state's attorney, Marilyn Mosby.
Right.
They're working with the police to pull out the dealers in that situation, and very similarly, Robert, treat them, U.S. Attorney Robert Herr, treat them like Project Exile does with guns. They're doing this with drugs. We have seen 3,200 people, Robert, overdose since 2007 through 2018. Overdose. That's, when you look at homicides, homicides are horrible.
Homicides are a problem.
But the overdoses outweigh them significantly.
And yet drugs, though, are a factor in some of these homicides.
Sure. But at the same time, though, we don't even really think of, because somebody doing it to themselves, to the same degree, the level of overdose deaths that we do the issue of homicide.
Still, the things we've learned, and I've learned, you know, from the health officials, doctors, professionals, is the way we rely on the way we view this. We have to view this as a disease. I mean, yes.
Well, we didn't until it became an opioid.
Right.
See, as long as it was heroin, it wasn't a disease. But now that it's opioid abuse, now it's a health issue. And I'm happy for that. But the issue of heroin, which has plagued this city, which is really the center of a lot of the problems, not just for Baltimore City, Robert, but for the surrounding jurisdictions, now that we have legal opioids involved, it has more of a health component to it.
One other thing in the news today, we've got a quarterly update from the federal court on the consent decree for Baltimore City Police. Among the things that the judge is asking for, an independent investigation into how the GTTF scandal happened. Also, he praised Michael Harrison, the judge praising Michael Harrison's selection as a police commissioner.
Also, Robert, in that announcement, Gary Tuggle, who's going to be leaving very soon, he is asking Johns Hopkins to help to find out how the GTTF was initiated. And I'm telling you, if we get to the source, this is over 10 years old. This thing started back in 2008, 2009, really, if you look at all the information that's in the federal court record. We need to know how this whole thing started. And if Gary Tuggle is able to do that outside of the police department, that will be amazing.
And as our friend Jane Miller points out, Melissa Hyatt, former city police commander, head security for Hopkins. C4 show back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.